Good morning, Bandar. In the last lecture, we have seen how to design an analog filter for the given specifications. In this lecture, we will try to see how to make use of that analog filter design techniques to implement a digital filter. We will try to implement digital filters with the help of analog filter design techniques. For example, with the help of Butterworth filter design, Chebyshev filter design, or elliptic filter design, like that. We'll try to make use of these analog filter design techniques in order to design the concerned digital filter. Let's have recap for that analog filter design. This transfer function corresponds to Butterworth low pass filter. HAFS. This is analog low pass filter. N is order of this Butterworth filter. Omega C is the 3 dB cutoff frequency for this. And the other specifications for the low pass filter, analog low pass filter. The delta P corresponds to minimum required pass band gain, and omega P is the pass band cutoff frequency. This delta S is the maximum allowed stop band gain, and omega S is the stop band cutoff frequency. If you know what is N, order of the filter, and what is omega C in this one, then we are done with our design. We can try to implement this system, right? The transfer function of analog low pass filter. With the help of these specifications, we will try to find the concerned N value and omega C by using these expressions. Once you got what is N value and what is omega C, then we can have the analog transfer function like this. Similarly, we have seen the design for Chebyshev filters also, right? Once we know what is the transfer function H of S, then we'll try to convert the transfer function into H of Z, digital filter, right? Digital filter means the corresponds to H of Z transfer function. Analog filter means H of S. We'll try to see a way to convert this S into Z. We'll try to convert this S as a function of Z so that we are going to end up with H of Z expression. That's what our target. That can be done with the help of a bilinear transformation, or you can say BLT, bilinear transformation. We are going to look into that one. Digital IIR filter design using bilinear transformation. The goal of this one is, first we will try to design the concerned analog filter. Once you got that analog filter H of S, the next step is we will try to transform that S into Z so that we are going to end up with required H of Z. H of Z is the concerned digital filter. That's a required digital filter, H of Z. Let's try to recall the background. Analog signal frequencies to equivalent digital signal frequencies mapping based on Nyquist sampling theorem. Earlier, we required twice the highest frequency of the message signal, right? FS means sampling rate, number of samples per second. That should be at least twice the highest frequency of the baseband message signal. Let us consider a continuous time signal as follows. It's a single tone, right? With a frequency of f hertz. And the concerned sampling rate is fs samples per second. Then you can try to sample this at every ts interval, where ts equals to 1 by fs. Ts equals to 1 by fs. If you simply replace this t with nts, at every ts interval, we are sampling this particular analog signal. Then we are going to end up with this discrete time signal where TS equals to 1 by FS. And this can be written like omega, small omega. Small omega equals to 2 pi f by fs. This is called as digital frequency, omega. Small omega is the digital frequency in radians per sample. Highest possible digital frequency is pi, which corresponds to fs by 2 in the analog frequency domain. Fs by 2 hertz corresponds to pi radians per sample in the digital domain. And high frequencies for digital signal are nearby odd multiples of pi. Low frequencies for digital signal are nearby even multiples of pi. In olden days, if we have given with analog transfer function h of s, we can simulate it using analog computer with the following operations. We have seen the transfer function h of s, right? Which is ratio of two polynomials in s. We have seen, right? Butterworth transfer function and Chebyshev transfer function. That is ratio of two polynomials in s. Denominator polynomial order is n and numerator polynomial order is 0, right? Because that is all pole system. If you want, you can cross check it once. Numerator don't contain any s terms, right? In those expressions. That's all pole system. That can be implementable with the help of addition operations, multiplication by a constant operation, and with the help of integrator. This transfer function can be simulated with the help of following operations: addition, multiplication by some constant, and integrator. People used op-amp for integrator, adder, multiplication with alpha. Potentiometer is enough if multiplication factor is less than 1. Integrator uses capacitor in the feedback. As you already know that integration corresponds to 1 by s, right? Laplace transform for integral is, suppose integral x of t, if you are having integral x of t, the Laplace transform for that one will be x of s divided by s, right? This 1 by s corresponds to integration operation. So if we simulate the transfer function using adders, multipliers, integrators, then we can convert that diagram into digital filter. In digital filter, addition remains same, multiplication remains same. Only change is we require a digital integrator. This is a philosophy behind bilinear transformation, and it has proved to be the best possible analytical design. Let's see how to have digital integrator. This is an analog integrator, y a of t equals to integral minus infinity to t x a of t dt. In order to get the digital integrator, we'll try to have the sampled version of this, y a of n t equals to y of n minus 1 into t plus integral n minus 1 into t to n t x a of t dt. You can see, right? This one corresponds to integration of x a of t till n minus 1 into t. This part is equal to integral minus infinity to n minus 1 into t x a of t dt, this part, plus this integration. If you try to club both of them, then we are going to end up with this expression, right? Integral minus infinity to n t x a of t dt, which is same as y a of n t. We can approximate this part by using trapezoidal rule. We can try to approximate this something like this, right? What we are doing here is, we are simply taking the average over these two limits. xi of n t plus xi of n minus 1 to t divided by 2, average of these two limit values, right, into t, where t corresponds to that rectangle width, the width with the gap between n minus 1 to t and n t corresponds to t, right, the t gap. So area under this curve, if t is very very small value, then approximately this flat in nature, right, xi of t, that's analog signal, this is just a approximation with the help of rectangle pulse. And the concerned digital representation will be y of n equals to y of n minus 1 plus t by 2 into x of n plus x of n minus 1. So you call as digital integrated. If you try to apply z transform both sides, then we are going to get the transfer function h of z equals to y of z by x of z, which is equals to t by 2 into 1 plus z power minus 1 by 1 minus z power minus 1. Is the transfer function for the integrated, digital integrated. H of s equals to 1 by s corresponds to transfer function for analog integrated, and this h of z corresponds to transfer function for digital integrated. So we can try to equate this 1 by s to this one, right? 1 by s equals to t by 2 into 1 by z power minus 1 by 1 minus z power minus 2. Analog integrated and digital integrated, we are trying to equate both of them. From there, you can try to have the conversion from s to z. 1 by s equals to this one. And if you try to flip that one, we are going to end up with s equals to 2 by t into 1 minus z power minus 1 by 1 plus z power minus 1. This is analog filter H of S. We are trying to convert that into digital filter H of Z with the help of this transformation. This is called as bilinear transformation. Why bilinear transformation means? It is just ratio of two linear polynomials in Z power minus 1, right? It's a linear polynomial in Z power minus 1. If Z power minus 1 is the variable, 1 minus Z power minus 1 is a linear polynomial. This is also a linear polynomial, right? The ratio of two linear polynomials in z power minus 1. So we can call it like bilinear transformation. And this concern h of z will be helpful when it is stable transfer function. Because by default, we will expect to have stable systems, right? You want to deal with always stable systems. We don't want to deal with unstable systems, right? We always require some bounded output for the bounded input. H of z should be a stable transfer function. It's a transformation we are applying. S as a function of z is a bilinear transformation. And if you try to rewrite in the other way, z as a function of s, you try to solve this, z power minus 1 equals to 1 by z, right? And after solving this, you are going to end up with this expression. Where s is complex number, Laplace, right? S equal to sigma plus j omega. S is capital omega. Substitute this S into this expression. After that, if you try to take the magnitude on both sides, this absolute value, magnitude on both sides, then we are going to end up with this expression. Real part space, this is imaginary part space. Same manner for this one. Suppose if sigma less than 0. Sigma less than 0 means the left half S plane, right? S plane is some complex thing, right? Sigma and j omega components. If sigma less than 0, it means that that's left half of S plane. if sigma less than 0 in this expression, this value will be smaller compared to this value, right? If sigma less than 0 means this part is negative, these two get subtracted. Sigma less than 0 in this case corresponds to this part will be minus of minus is positive, right? This will be added. This term will be bigger compared to this term, right? If sigma less than 0. And these two terms are equal. Overall, you can say this denominator part is more than numerator part, right? Then this value will be less than 1. It means sigma less than 0 mapped to margin less than 1. Left half of S plane mapped to area in the unit circle, right? Within unit circle. Left half of S plane mapped to margin less than 1. And sigma equal to 0 mapped to margin equal to 1. Margin equal to 1 corresponds to unit circle. This is unit circle, right? Sigma equal to 0 corresponds to j omega axis. Sigma equal to 0 means S equal to j omega, right? This corresponds to j omega axis, or that imaginary axis in the S plane. Imaginary axis in the S plane mapped to unit circle in the z plane, right? Mod z equal to 1. If sigma greater than 0, this will be bigger compared to this one. It means that numerator is more than denominator. We can say this is above 1, mod z greater than 1. It means right half of S plane mapped to outside of unit circle. Left half of S plane mapped to inside of unit circle. So a stable system H A of S will be transformed to a stable system H of Z with the help of bilinear transformation. The reason behind this one is, suppose if you consider stable analog system H A of S, if all poles are left side of S plane, then we can have a stable and causal system, right? If all poles are in the left half of S plane. According to this theory, if the pole is lying in the left half of S plane, that will be mapped to inside unit circle, right? In the Z plane. That will be within unit circle. And we already know, right? If all poles are within the unit circle, then you can try to say that can be stable and causal system. That probability is there, right? It's a mapping of S plane onto the Z plane using bilinear transformation. This is S plane, real part, this is imaginary part. See, mod Z equal to 1, unit circle. You can try to see this J omega axis will be mapped to mod Z equal to 1, this unit circle. And this left half of S plane mapped to inner part of unit circle. This will be mapped to this one. And this part will be mapped to this outside of unit circle. Suppose if a pole is somewhere here, that will be mapped to somewhere in this part, right? This is left half of S plane. The pole is lying on left half of S plane. That will be mapped to a pole within unit circle, inside the unit circle, when coming to Z plane. So after bilinear transformation, J omega axis transformed to mod Z equal to 1. Mod Z equal to 1 means Z equal to e power J omega. If you try to substitute this, S equal to j omega and Z equal to e power j omega. And once you simplify this one, we are going to end up with this expression. Capital omega equals to 2 by t tan small omega by 2. It's a digital frequency in radians per sample. It's an analog frequency in radians per second. And from this we can say omega greater than 0 map to small omega from 0 to pi, and omega less than 0 map to small omega from pi to 2 pi. It means positive frequencies are mapped to 0 to pi, negative frequencies are mapped to pi to 2 pi interval. If you simplify this one, small omega equals to 2 tan inverse capital omega t by 2. This is a nonlinear relationship between small omega and capital omega, and it is 1 to 1 mapping. This is 1 to 1 mapping between small omega and capital omega. You have the graph of this capital omega. This is small omega. In law of frequency in radians per second, this omega equals to 2 pi f. This is small omega in radians per sample. This is 0 to pi. This is minus pi to 0. Small omega equals to 2 tan inverse capital omega t divided by 2. This is one-to-one mapping, right? You can try to see. You can consider any frequency in this one that is mapped uniquely to this one. This is one-to-one mapping. This is monotone, right? It's monotonically increasing. You can see this. Omega from 0 to infinity mapped to small omega from 0 to pi. Capital omega from minus infinity to 0 mapped to this part, right? Small omega from 0 to minus pi, or you can say pi to 2 pi, anything is fine. According to this relation, we can say it's a nonlinear mapping between small omega and capital omega. And it is one-to-one mapping. The infinite interval 0 to infinity is mapped to finite interval 0 to pi, right? This infinite interval in the analog domain mapped to finite interval 0 to pi in the digital domain. Some compressed version, right? This is called as frequency warping. It's a warping effect. We can take care of this by doing pre-warping, or you can say it as anti-warping. Frequency warping inherent in bilinear transformation of a continuous time low-pass filter into a discrete time low-pass filter. To achieve the desired discrete time cutoff frequencies, the continuous time cutoff frequencies must be pre-warped as indicated in this figure. You can try to see this one. This is a digital filter specifications. This corresponds to the concerned analog filter specifications. This is small omega, this is capital omega. Here the cutoff frequency, digital cutoff frequency is small omega p. This is a pass band cutoff frequency. Small omega is corresponds to stop band cutoff frequencies. This is a bilinear transformation, right? Capital omega equals to 2 by t and omega by 2. This small omega p mapped to capital omega p through this nonlinear relation. This capital omega p equals to 2 by t and omega p by 2. Say 2 by t tan omega p by 2. And this cap small omega is mapped to capital omega s, 2 by t tan omega s by 2. And these specifications remain same. Suppose this is the delta p. This is delta p. Minimum allowed passband gain is delta p. Then this will be delta p. This also delta p. Same as that. If this corresponds to delta s, maximum allowed stopband gain, then this also will be delta s, maximum allowed stop band gain. These two will be same. This is called as pre-warping. we are trying to map omega p into this one, and we are trying to map this small omega s into this capital omega s. Suppose someone asks you to design digital filter with these following specifications, then what we are going to do is, first we will try to design analog filter with these specifications. With these specifications, once you got the constant HA of S, then we simply try to apply S equals to 2 by T into 1 minus Z power minus 1 by 1 plus Z power minus 1. That bilinear transformation. We simply apply that bilinear transformation and we will try to convert that H of S into H of Z, where H of Z is the constant digital filter with these specifications. For that, we are doing pre-warping. This is called as pre-warping. For this omega p, the constant capital omega p will be this one. For this omega s, this is a constant stop band cutoff frequency. If you want to design this digital filter, we will try to design the analog filter with the following specifications like this. After that, we will simply apply bilinear transformation, that s as a function of z. That's the procedure we are going to apply. It's a most famous method, bilinear transformation, to design digital filter with the given specifications. Thank you.